getting started with NASA's Visible Infrared Imaging Radiometer Suite, or VIRS, Surface Reflectance Data Part 1, all about accessing data, presented by the Land Processes Distributed Active Archive Center, or LPDAC. This video is part 1 of the Getting Started with NASA's VIRS Surface Reflectance Data video series. This video will provide information about the NASA VIRS satellite sensor, the NASA VIRS Surface Reflectance Data products, and how to search for and download these data using NASA's Earth Data Search Client Data Access Tool. The VIRS satellite sensor is one of 5 instruments on board the SWAMI National Polar Orbiting Partnership SNPP satellite. SNPP was launched on October 28, 2011, and is the first in a series of 4 Joint Polar Satellite Systems (JPSS) satellites. VIRS is part of a collaborative mission between the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, and NASA. NASA is applying algorithms similar to the algorithms used in Moderate Resolution Imaging Spectroradiometer (MODIS) data to the NASA VIRS data. NASA VIRS data are considered a continuation of the MODIS data, just as MODIS data are a continuation of Advanced Very High Resolution Radiometer (AVHRR) data. VIRS observes the entire Earth's surface twice each day from a polar orbit at 824 kilometers or 512 miles above the Earth's surface. The 3,000 kilometers swath width of the VIRS instrument, which is 710 kilometers greater than that of MODIS, allows for no gaps in coverage, similar to those observed in MODIS near the equator. The VIRS instrument provides 22 spectral bands at 2 spatial resolutions, 375 meters and 750 meters, which are resampled to 500 meters, 1 kilometer, and 5,600 meters in the NASA-produced data products to promote consistency with the MODIS heritage. The LPDAC distributes 4 different types of VIRS surface reflectance products. These include 2 daily VIRS surface reflectance products and 2 8-day surface reflectance products. All data distributed by the LPDAC are available for download at no charge. VIRS data are distributed as Hierarchical Data Format Earth Observing System 5 or HDF-EOS-5 products. The VIRS surface reflectance products are Level 3 products, meaning they have been atmospherically corrected, gridded into a map projection, and temporally composited. The daily surface reflectance products are available as a 0.05 degree or 5,600 meter Global Climate Modeling Grid or CMG, and as a 1 kilometer or 500 meter tiled product in sinusoidal projection based on the MODIS sphere. The 8-day surface reflectance products are available as 1 kilometer and 500 meter tiled products, also in sinusoidal projection. Data products are available from January 19, 2012 to present. Detailed information about each of the individual products can be found on the LPDAC website at lpdac.usgs.gov. The surface reflectance data are created by adjusting top of atmosphere reflectance to compensate for atmospheric effects. Corrections are made for the effects of molecular gases, including ozone and water vapor, and for the effects of atmospheric aerosols. The VIRS surface reflectance products contain 2 different types of surface reflectance bands. The M indicates bands with a nadir resolution of 750 meters, which are resampled to 1 kilometer. The I indicates bands with a nadir resolution of 375 meters, resampled to 500 meters. The M bands are only in the VIRS surface reflectance products that provide 1 kilometer spatial resolution, including the 8-day VNP-09A1 product and the daily VNP-09GA product. Likewise, the I bands are only in the VIRS surface reflectance products that provide a 500 meter spatial resolution, including the 8-day VNP-09H1 product and the daily VNP-09GA product. The Daily Climate Modeling Grid VNP-09CMG product contains both the I and M bands, but at a 0.05 degree or approximately 5,600 meter spatial resolution. The VIRS surface reflectance products contain bands that are in a spectral range that is similar to the MODIS surface reflectance bands, but not exact. The LPDAC website also offers several ways to download VIRS surface reflectance data products. At the bottom of the DOI landing page for each product are links to useful data access tools. In this video, downloading data using NASA's Earth Data Search Client Data Access Tool will be demonstrated step by step. The Earth Data Search homepage can also be accessed from the Tools section of the LPDAC website. From the Earth Data Search homepage, search.earthdata.nasa.gov, click on the Earth Data Login button to log in with your NASA Earth Data account. If you do not have an Earth Data account, click on the Register button and follow the prompt to create one. Now search for the VIRS Daily Surface Reflectance 1 km and 500 meter Level 3 gridded product VNP09GA. Type VNP09GA in the search bar and hit enter. Click on the VNP09GA data product. This will pull up all of the VNP09GA granules. Parameters for a specific time and location can be set above the map. For this video, let's look at the daily surface reflectance for the United States city of Portland, Oregon during the summer of 2012. First, pan and zoom the map to Portland. Change the temporal range by clicking on the temporal icon and then click on the start date and change the date to June 20, 2012. Now change the end date to September 21st, 2012, and click on Apply Filter. To change the spatial information, click on the spatial icon and select Rectangle from the drop-down menu. Draw a rectangle around Portland. You will now see green outlines that indicate the footprint of the VIRS tile contained in your rectangle. The granules from 2012 that are located in the selected area are now listed in the white box at the bottom of the page. Above the granule list are options to download data, which allows a user to download all of the matching granules, an eye icon to learn more about the data collection, a filter icon to further filter the data, and a plus sign icon, which allows a user to add multiple data products to their Earth Data Search project. Click on the first box containing a scene in the bottom white box to select the most recent scene. This box contains a preview of the granule, the VIRS file name, the dates of the data, an X in the upper right-hand corner to remove the scene from your granule list, an I for more information, and the retrieval icon to download a single granule. Click on the I icon to bring up the metadata for the selected granule. Remember, metadata are data about data. The metadata include the DOI, which is necessary for proper citation, as well as information on the scene's corner coordinates, input granules, and more. Click on the metadata tab for links to download metadata in different standard formats. Click on Back to Granules to return to the granule list. Click on Download Data to download all of the granules in the granule list. Now, review the data download order on the Data Access page. This page lists the number of granules in the order and the size of the order. From here, users can select the service options. Select Direct Download to instantly receive the granules in the order, or select Stage for Delivery to receive the granules via email. Click on Submit or Continue and then Submit to submit the order. Depending on the data access method, the data can be accessed immediately or will be sent to the user via email. Thank you for watching our video. For more information on NASA's VIRS surface reflectance data, please visit the LPDAC website at lpdac.usgs.gov.